Our key message is that the governor's pension reform Tier 6 proposal is necessary and responsible. This reform will save over $100 billion over the course of 30 years. And while all that savings doesn't come in 1 year, if you were just to divide and say, well, that's about $3 billion a year, that's $3 billion every year that the state and local governments have in their pockets to spend on education, on school aid, $3 billion a year that they don't have to go look for raising taxes to find the money so that they can continue to afford really unreasonable pension plans that are no longer the standard outside of state government and that aren't the standard anywhere else in the world. Pension reform is not an attack on the middle class. Pension reform protects the middle class, who pay the vast majority of the taxes and fees that support our governments, that are going to be required to come up with the dollars to keep these pension plans whole if we don't undertake a reform right now. The last thing I really want to say about the governor's pension reform proposal is it does offer an alternative, a choice, for the first time to state employees. They don't have to be part of the state pension system. Instead, they can opt to have a 401k style plan that will allow them to take their benefits with them when they leave state government. For people who don't work in state government for 10 years or 15 years or whatever the period of time is that you vest under any given plan, this is something that is a benefit that doesn't currently exist for anyone outside of the SUNY or CUNY system. And by the way, where they were given the option in the SUNY and CUNY system, better than 70% of those employees opted for the 401k style plan. So I think it's important to recognize that, you know, for folks who are saying, A, this is a war on the middle class, take a step back and think about it. The middle class is paying the taxes to support these bloated pension costs. B, this only applies to new employees. Nobody is having anything taken away from them here. This is for people who are hired at a future date by the state, and it provides them with a choice that current employees don't currently have. There's nothing wrong with having a choice. In fact, where other SUNY and CUNY employees were given the choice, as I mentioned, 70% of them opted for the 401k style plan. This is something that is a long time coming. It is a tool that state and local governments will be able to have the means to afford to provide the essential services that they're there to provide in the future.